Bientôt les mains, mingang lo biolo, mi abonné na chaîne. Salut les gars, n'oubliez pas, abonnez-vous à la chaîne. Mi gente bonitos, no olviden, inscríbete al canal. Hey guys, don't forget, subscribe to the channel.
Sometimes when I come, I want to keep my energy down. But you guys have been activating this, my joyful energy. All of you guys subscribing to this channel, may God bless you, Jerry. You guys are the real people now. I will not cry for you. No. Because I know you guys want me to cry. You want me to do something, but I will not do it. You know why?
Nah. French people say nah.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for liking. Oh, thank you for subscribing. Oh, thank you for the comments. Oh, thank you for the sharing. Oh, why now? Why are you guys so nice to me? I don't deserve it. Okay, maybe I deserve it more. I hope you guys are doing well. If this is your first time here, do not forget to subscribe. Subscribe right now. Click the subscribe button. Like, give this video a thumbs up. Comment, give me good accolades. I need accolades. You guys know that I'm an accolade babe. Accolade forever for me. As you can see from this video, all this talk that I'm doing now, I'm thirsty. Guys, you know what I have in this, my cup? You want to know the secret to what's in my cup? What is my joyful drink? My joyful juice. So, I definitely needed to come and tell you guys about my tea and my aloe. If you're a student, it doesn't matter. You need energy, you need good energy, you need to feel good. These are natural products. You already know I'm an Herbalife giant forever. These two things, I will definitely leave the link in the comments description sections, okay? So you guys can go and get it. Definitely will help you, give you the energy you need. Whether you're working out or you're going about your day in the morning, instead of coffee, you can drink this. These two, they're very good, okay? And you also get 20% off on your order. So I'll also give that coupon code in the description box. Guys, are you ready for today? No, it seems as if you guys are not ready for today, because me, as you can see from the title today, it's like my heart is so connected to this, my topic, the 10 guidelines, 10 effective guidelines to finish and do well with this, your community college career. Guys, I don't want you to spend 5 years just taking one class, not knowing what to do, who to run for, who to run for. run for me, please. Eh? So today in our 10 guidelines, I will divide it into part one and part two. First thing I need you guys to know, there are about 3 groups of people that attend community college. People that end up high school career, they get their high school diploma, have really good grades. But the thing is, they don't know what to do. They don't know what they want to do with their careers, and they don't want to waste money. They go to community college, the 2 years, because normally the community college program is 2 years. Most states, 60 credits to graduate, to get your associate degree, okay? So good grade people go, bad grade people go, I'm part of that, okay? So you want to go there to raise up your GPA so that you can attend that your university of your choice. And then the third one is, I think we all fall under that umbrella, is the immigrant foreigner umbrella, where you come, if you're not coming from an British educational system, you have to take a language class or an ESL class, English as a second language, or some of you guys automatically go through the community college tunnel. So if that's you, may God bless you. Like, a lot of people don't go through that, but the point is that there are difficulties in really understanding what you need in order to finish that your program effectively on time and to be able to start this, your 4-year program. So today I'm here to give you guys the first 5. The first one is that you need to know your admissions office. Admissions office is so important. Some of you guys take that building as a joke. Me, sometimes I don't even want to go, because most of the time when you go, it's like you have a heart attack, the way they look at you. But that does not, it does not give you a reason not to go, okay? You need to go to the admissions office. In the admissions office, you would find how to apply for your Fafsa, how to get, you know, to know about your expenses, your scholarships, all these details, okay? Financial aid is such a must, because that's what you need to even attend the school. For you guys already enrolled in community college, you know how to apply for Fafsa. For you guys who don't and want me to do a video on it, let me know. And we can definitely talk about how to go through the tunnel of applying for Fafsa. Okay, your expenses, get a notebook. Write down what you need. Is it books? Is it calculator? Gloves? White coat? Research? Whatever you need, write it down. Because the thing is, although you're getting a certain amount from financial aid, you don't want to just use it on anything. Financial aid money is not for you to go to your restaurant and go to H&M and buy clothes and looking like a slay queen, slay mama. No. Or slay king. No. It's for you to use it for the right things. So write down your expenses down. Me, I'm very cheap. Everybody knows that. Yes. But I cannot come and keep myself, please. I will not just try to impress anybody. I need to impress myself. Yes. So use the money wisely. Please, guys, we will have a video on financial aid and financial literacy in the future. So we'll talk a little bit about that. And then scholarship. Community colleges, they do have scholarships. You have to ask. Some of you guys don't ask. You just assume that they don't. Please ask about the scholarships available for you. And also independent scholarships. I'm going to put the links down. Please go and click on them and see which one you are in alignment with so you can apply. Most of them, they'll ask you for a personal statement or a letter of interest. Why are you applying for these scholarships? If you guys want me to do a video on strong personal statement, what needs to be in your personal statement, please let me know, okay? So we can get you there, get you the plenty money. Plenty me is, I love money. I'm just cheap. You see, I don't know. It's like there's no balance. I'm very cheap. I'm a cheap human being. I'm not ashamed of it. Some of you guys want to make me to be ashamed of this, my cheapness. I will not be. I cannot be. Also, churches, your church, your mosque, your synagogue, all these, it doesn't matter which religion you are part of. They have funding for you as a student. So you need to ask. Me, I was blessed enough as an undergrad, my church, shout out to Mount Carmel. They funded my way to Spain. They funded my way to Korea when I was doing my studied abroad program. They did things that, it's so funny because I ask. You have to ask, okay? So make sure that you are using this knowledge of this. You know, you just don't want to go say, I'm only going to church. No. You are going to church, you are a member. Members, they have, you know, they have requirements and they also have accolades, okay? So be present in that your entity, your religious entity, okay? Ask questions, okay? Because churches do have funding. Mosques have funding. Synagogues, I'm not for sure they have funding, okay? And then last but not least, nonprofits around your area that deal with immigration, that deal with students, that deal with foreigners, they have funding. So you need to ask. Asking is not something you should be ashamed of. That's where you get money for school. In this country, they have it. You don't have to struggle so much. Okay, guys, so that's number one. Number two, make sure that you know where to get your curriculum guide. Guys, your curriculum guide is the wheel of the car. You cannot go anywhere without knowing what you need to take, the classes you need to take, in what you need to actually graduate in 2 years. 2 years, not five. Please, not five. I'm talking about maximum 2 years. Talking about curriculum guide, number three. You need to figure out who your academic advisor is. Sometimes you guys just go. You apply for Fafsa, you get your curriculum guide somewhere, and you just go. No. Design your plan. Design it. Go and see them and say, these are things that I'm, classes I'm taking first semester. These are classes I'm taking second semester. These are classes I'm taking third semester, fourth semester. Maybe I'll take two courses in the summer. Boom. Ask them if it's in alignment with your graduation time. They will tell you. That's how you finish anything effectively, because you have a plan. Now, we do plan, but life, things happen. But the point is that is you are planning. At least you are planning. Okay, guys? So make sure that you go see your academic advisor. How do you find your academic advisor? You can ask at the admissions office or go on the website, okay? Your school website. They sure would have information about that, okay? Number four, register for classes immediately. Remember, you are in a community college, meaning that the amount of people applying and registering for those classes are plenty. You can't just say, when I have time on Saturday, I'll go register. The open class on Monday, you are registering for classes on Saturday. Classes that you need to graduate, sometimes they will be full. Now you wait another semester because you were too lazy to go and register. When they said the class open at midnight, go and register for classes. Okay, register for classes. You already have your curriculum guide. You talk to your advisor. You have the classes you need. Classes open, register. Okay, number five, which is my favorite one, please do not just take classes. 60 credits to graduate. Yet, when you are ready to transfer, they are telling you that most of your credits are not transferable. They are not transferable, and you are just confused. You say, ah, but you guys said that I only need 30 or 40. So while you just enroll and you start your first semester, reach out to your future or potential university and ask them. Most of the time, this question goes to the university or the undergraduate student advisor. Please write this down. It goes to the undergraduate student advisor. That's the person you will email or you will call and say, ah, I'll be transferring there in 2 years. Or, you know, I'm already enrolled in this, my community college, and I really want to know which classes are transferable. Is there a guide? They will send you a curriculum, or they will tell you these are the classes you need, or these are the many credits you need. This is the GPA that you need. It prepares you and puts you in alignment with your future plans. Okay, guys? So number one, admissions office, make sure you find out how to apply for Fafsa, financial aid, get to know your expenses. And number three, find out about scholarship on campus. I will be putting the independent scholarships in the description here. And talk to your church, talk to your mosque, talk to your synagogue, talk to any religion establishment that you're part of. Also, make sure that you get in contact with a non-profit in your area, because they can also help. Number two, get to know your curriculum guide. Find, you know, what do you need? When do you need it? Number three, figure out who your academic advisor is. Please, it is very important. Number four, register for classes immediately. And how do you know this? When you are at the admissions office, ask them, when do they open the online thing for me to register for classes? If they said midnight, register for classes. Number five, make sure that those are your classes that you are taking now or in 2 years while you finish are transferable when you're ready to pursue your four-year career. Guys, I am so fascinated about this topic because it brings me joy. Although I was not part of the community college community, I know a lot of you guys struggle just to understand how to actually finish effectively. And so next week, I will be, I would follow with the other five, but I really want you guys to know that the first five are very dear to my heart. They are very, very dear to my heart. That's the foundation of how you will get to where you need to be, okay? I am so grateful for what you guys do for me every week. And coming here, watching these videos, subscribing, commenting, liking, may God bless you. I'm so grateful. Thank you guys so much. And do not forget, I will be dropping videos on Sunday, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.